Le groupe du jour, hein, so the band of the day is still Daft Punk, and it's extremely interesting because it's extremely rare to find interviews of Daft Punk, because once they decided to become robots, it was almost impossible to ask them to speak and to talk and to answer a few questions. So we have the luck to have some an interview, and so I've been, of course, slicing the interview, and we are going to work on what they say. So, of course, these are robots, so we don't know who will talk, but I think it's quite interesting because, well, these are French people, so clearly it will be maybe less challenging than what we had previously. We'll see. We start with the number one. As usual, I will make it roll. So it means that you will have the time to try to catch all the words and try to write everything. Allez-y.
On est relativement timide. 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 On est relativement timide.
Oops, you didn't see the thing. I'm sorry about that. Hop là, voilà, you get the full thing, sorry.
On est relativement timide. 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 On est relativement timide.
Allez-y. Alors oui, hein. It's going fast, don't worry about that, that's the idea of the exercise. We will have the time to listen to them, to work on their pace and their way of talking, and so, but you just need to be really patient. If it doesn't come right now, it's totally normal. So the things that, one of them was saying is, on est relativement timid. I've been cutting like that, so maybe something else was right after, but let's agree on the fact that it was on est relativement timide. So let's listen to that one more time.
On est relativement timide. On est relativement timide.
Voilà. So clearly the way it's structured, so he's going for the on. Remember that we are using on in most of the cases instead of nous. So he's talking about the two robots. And so that's the reason why I've been putting the S at the end of timide, hein, because of course this timide goes for the two of them. On est relativement timide. On est relativement timide. So let's listen to him one more time. It goes quite fast, but don't worry, you will get used to the pace.
On est relativement timide. On est relativement timide.
Voilà. Allez, let's go for numéro 2. We continue with the number 2. Numéro 2, same thing here. I wanted to, as usual, make some short thing for, to start. Let's go for it.
On a réalisé un film. 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 On a réalisé un film.
Allez-y, try to write what you heard.
On
Gloria. No, there is no accent in that case. You don't hear it. No, there is no southern accent or no. They're coming from Paris, and clearly it's accent free, I would say. Alors, the thing was, on a réalisé un film. On a réalisé un film. So same thing here. He's going for the on instead of the nous. So it means that of course when it comes to conjugation, it's going faster because it's like shorter version. So it's not nous avons réalisé un film, but then it's on a réalisé un film. On a réalisé un film. Alors attendez, let's go for it. On a réalisé un film. Listen.
On a réalisé un film.
I think it's quite clear. In fact, it's going quite fast, but still, it goes for the on a, so connection between on and a, which is totally normal. So I would personally do exactly the same. On a réalisé, quite clearly pronounced, un film. So on a réalisé un film. Let's listen to that one more time and have a look at it.
On a réalisé un film. On a réalisé un film.
Voilà, that's it. Hein. On a réalisé un film. Cosmina, est-ce qu'ils ont montré leur visage? Oui. Avant, before 2000, they were showing their faces, but in 2000, they just decided to start hiding their faces. So after that, it was they were never ever showing their face. So and they never had any problem with the media. and because people didn't know what they look like, and in fact, in most of the cases, they'd rather take the subway or all these transportation just to be normal, which is quite interesting. Allez, on y va. Numéro 3. Attention. I'm sorry. Voilà. Same thing here. It's quite short, but I think it's quite good to start with the short things. Allez-y.
On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait. 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 On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait.
Allez-y. Alors, yeah. So, yeah, because I've been cutting. I didn't put the en fait, I guess. Let me check. Oops, sorry.
On s'était pas vraiment préparé, en fait.
Oh, yeah, it's true. I didn't put the en fait. I'm sorry about that. Ah, that's the way it goes. Voilà. Allez, let's put it like that. On s'était pas vraiment préparé. En fait, alors after that, there is a discussion, but let's not get into the details. So I've been putting as an option the S, because in most of the cases, of course, if you think about the conjugation, normally if it's on, then you don't need to put the plural form, but then it can be discussed and it has been discussed among French people and people who like the language. In some cases, we might consider that just to be coherent. If we put, the plural in the adjective, so we might have to put the plural also to the past participle when needed. So it's up to you, it's an option. So on s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait. I think it's in fact, it's quite clear, so let's listen to them.
On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait.
Ouais, it is quite clear. So take the time, I will make it roll maybe 3 times. Just take the time to get used to the pace and look at, read at the same time.
On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait. On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait. On s'était pas vraiment préparé en fait.
Voilà. So you will see that little by little now you will get used to the way he talks. The way he talks, and I think it should be
ça va super okay. Bien.
I don't know why Céline Dion is still here. It's the ghost of Céline Dion. Allez, let's go for it.
On était très optimiste. 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 On était très optimiste.
Allez-y. Alors, in that case, it was on était très optimiste. Hein? On était très optimiste. So, same thing here. He's using on. So, obviously, était should be written E, accent aigu, T-A-I-T. Très optimiste. Alors, so that's the concept, as I told you, because this on, even if it belongs to the third person of the singular, yet it expresses a plural. So, it means that normally, I mean, to be logical, we should put optimiste in the plural form because he's talking about the two of them. So, on était très optimiste. Same thing here. It seems that now you are getting used to it. So, it's quite good. So, let's listen to it.
On était très optimiste. On était très optimiste.
As you can see, it's quite clear, in fact. Hein? On était très optimiste. So he's making the liaison between très and optimiste. But I think that everything is quite clear in terms of pronunciation. Hein? So it goes fast. We agree on that. But still, take the time. Same thing, I will make it roll 3 times. Try to listen and read at the same time.
On était très optimiste. On était très optimiste. On était très optimiste.
Allez, voilà. Merci beaucoup. On continue. Numéro 5. So this is getting a bit longer, as you can see. But same thing here. Well, I will let you try to write the thing.
Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
Sorry.
Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
Allez-y. We'll be right back. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So, because... Oopla, sorry. The translation was missing in that case. I think we might have some surprises today. So, mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. So it seems that you catch the thing quite well. So apparently you didn't want to put... Bulle was not really clear for everybody. Renato had it with the two L's, but Yesero aussi. Few others were missing it. We had some bull, we had some bull, we had some bull with one L. Bon, but it's okay. Alors, let's listen to the thing just to check the pronunciation. So I would say, mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
Voilà. I think it's quite clear.
On s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
So you can see, I mean, the pace is not that fast, in fact. And once and now, I guess it's the same for you. You start to get used to the way he pronounces, to his pace. So you, it's quite clear now. So just take the time to have a look at the thing and listen to it at the same time.
Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle. Mais on s'était un peu créé une sorte de bulle.
Voilà, très bien. Olga wants the translation. Une bulle, it's a bubble, so he wants to say that clearly they were creating some kind of bubble to be able to create their album. So he was referring to the last album, this Random Access Memories. So they had to be like in a bubble to make it and to create it. So bulle is a bubble. Hein, c'est une bulle de savon peut-être. Allez, merci beaucoup. Merci.